morning. Welcome to Clean Slate Farm. Today we're going to talk about making soil blocks and my mixture for making soil blocks. What I do is I use peat moss, garden compost, compost that we've made from horse manure, straw, grass leaves, the usual stuff, vegetable scraps and everything. I also add to this mixture a little bit of green sand, a little bit of blood meal, some lime to help amend the soil, and some perlite to help keep it loosened up. What I use for the mixture is about 4 gallons, 5 gallons of compost, mix in about 2.5 gallons of peat moss, and then I start amending it with this. And I will only use about 3 ounces of this, blood meal, lime, and perlite. I'll use about 64 ounces, maybe 3 or 4. This is a 32-ounce container, so maybe 3 or 4 of these, 2 or 3 of these, I'm sorry. And then I mix it all up, put it in this bin, wet it down, let it sit for a few minutes, and then we'll start making soil blocks. This is the soil block maker, and you'll see I keep it in water over here. That's just to help keep it loose when we make the block, and you'll see that in a few minutes. So let's start mixing some up. We'll get some going right now. So we're back again, and what I've got here is the mixture that I'll mixed up, and it's all put together, and it looks like I might have a little bit more perlite in there than I thought beginning, but use your judgment. It should look about like this. You should have fine grains of the perlite all through it. And then what I'm going to do is add water. I've got 6 of these containers in here, plus I'm going to add about 2.5 containers of this of water and add it, amend it a little bit with more water just to make it so it's squeezable and doesn't fall apart. You want kind of a gushy, clay-like mix to it. You'll see that in a second as well. So let's start there. So we're going to add some water to this mix, and you can't see me, which is probably a good thing, but we're going to add the water to this mix, mix it up, and I'll show you how it should look. So I'm going to add 3 containers, and that one's got a hole in it. So we're going to move over here and grab this one, which doesn't have a hole in it. We'll fill right up to this rim here. And I'm doing this because out of experience, I've learned about how much, what the ratio is. I'm going to add 2, and then this is where it gets nice and sloppy. Just mix it up. It's kind of like making cookie dough or something. Just keep mixing it in, bringing it in, slopping it up. Water's going to go all over. A little bit like kneading dough. And you'll see it's starting to come together now, where it sticks a little bit more, but it's still a little loose and there's still a lot of dry stuff in there. Keep turning it, mixing it, and it's about ready for a little bit more water. Add just a little bit more here. And it is indeed sloppy. You can see all over my hands, it's pretty mucky stuff, but boy, it works well. Scoop it up from the sides, make sure it's mixed well. Turn and squish. It's kind of fun, it's like being a kid again. After I've got this mixed together, what I want to do is let it sit so the peat moss can absorb the water. And it'll be just about the right texture. From experience again, I know that if I squeeze it, and if you can see the water squishing out of that a little bit, dripping down the sides, that's about what you want. Not too much wetter than that. Now, after it sits a minute, what will happen is the peat will absorb that, and it'll be nice and mixed. And you know what? I think I want just a little bit more water in there. So add just a little bit more. And mix just a little bit more. You want to make sure that you get it all mixed up nice and well. You'll see why in a few minutes when we get going here. I'm mixing up the my cell phone dinging over there. You start making the blocks proper, you'll see why. If you have a dry spot, the block will fall apart. You don't want that to happen. You want it just the right texture. Soil blocks are interesting because what you do is you water from the bottom. And we'll talk about that a little bit more when we plant some seeds in here in part 2 of this little demonstration. That looks good right now. If I squeeze, just about the right water content. So, I'm going to leave it loose, get it all in the center here. I'm going to squish it together, not just yet. It's going to sit for about 5 minutes or so. That should absorb. I'm going to wash my hands off here. Don't want to do that. Wash my hands off and we'll get going again. Okay, let's start making some soil blocks here. Remember I talked earlier about keeping this wet, and what you want to do is keep the inside of this wet. It helps release the mixture a little bit. So it's been about 5 minutes or so. So we're going to start making some soil blocks. And the way you do it is grab hold, push some mixture in there, grab some more mixture, push the mixture in, twist it. I look at the bottom, nicely packed. And then it's a simple matter of lay that on the ground, leave the bottom part touching, and then just pull up and you'll see the bottom part pushes up and lift, and away you go, soil blocks. Let's do another one. Just mush it in there. Good. It's probably wet enough. I don't have to wet it enough in the water. Look at the bottom. Looks pretty good. Again, lift up, squish, and away you go. Each of these soil blocks has a little indentation in the top. When I get a close-up, you'll see that better. And the tub that I'm using here is what we call in the restaurant business that I work in, is called a fish tub. And it's what fish purveyors send the fish in. They lay all the slabs of fish inside there and the pieces of fish inside. And you can probably get these at your local grocery store, your bigger grocery stores. Might be able to get it if you have a fish purveyor in town. We have a couple of those in town. I happen to get them at the restaurant because we go through a lot of fish where I work. So make another soil block here. Again, you want to make sure you get a good compression on that. You want to jam that dirt inside there. Get mix inside. Looks pretty good. And you can see water drizzling out of there. That means it's got a good mix. Put it in again. I like to leave a little bit of air in between the blocks. Now, soil blocks are interesting because what happens is as the plant and seedling grows in there, it hits the air. Oh, I see, I got one soil block that fell apart. So I'm going to do that whole batch over. As it hits the air, it stops growing. It's kind of a natural barrier for the seeds. And I'll put 4 across and 2 over here. So I'll get 8, 16, and another 8. So we'll get 24 blocks out of this. There we go. We'll wet it again. Make another one. Now we'll get in there and get you a close-up so you can see what the soil block looks like with a little indentation in there. Check the bottom. Getting some good water mix coming up, so I know the soil block is wet enough for me. For the container, you can use just about any container you want. I happen to use these because they're easily obtained for me. You could also use, I guess, your standard slotted seed starting trays that you buy at the store, the little green ones that are about roughly the same size with the ribs in the bottom. You could use those too, I guess. These I like, again, because I can get them cheap, which is free. So in 2 seconds, we'll come back and show you the blocks and how the indentation works. Okay, so we've got the blocks made, and I'll show you, got a mess of blocks here. And you'll see the little indentation, and I just knocked the blocks over. You see the little indentation at the top of the blocks. That's where the seed will go. And I got a mess of them made there. I just planted in here some lavender. I'm going to plant some more lavender. I ran out of mix. That's why I've got an empty hole there. I'm going to plant some more lavender. We have bees going in this year, and we want to make sure the bees are fed. And lavender is just beautiful and smells wonderful, so I really like that. So I'm going to show you how I did that just in a second. I'm going to move this off to the side here. Bring another box of blocks down. And I have to remember to mark those. This is true lavender, lavender angustifolia. A friend of mine, Karen Lockwood at Lockwood Lavender Farm, told me that would be a very good lavender to grow here. It's good and winter hardy in our climate. So what I just did was I just took a screwdriver, a Phillips head screwdriver. I have the seeds on a paper plate, and just shake them around a little bit. Wet the end of the screwdriver just a little bit. And you put the seed in, give it a little twist. The seed is gone. Wet it, shake it off a little bit. And you keep doing that. Pick up seeds, put it in the hole. Work in a logical fashion so you keep track of where you're going, because once the seed's in there, you really can't see it anymore. Unless you really got good eyes. And I don't have, as you can tell, glasses. I don't have good eyes anymore. So we'll put that in there. No seed. Do another one. Bear with me, we'll get all these done. It'll only take a second. Started using soil blocks a couple of years ago. And we started out with two different size block makers. The one I'm using here is an inch and a half, 2 inch I think it is. And we started with a real small one as well. Ooh, I got some lavender seeds floating around in the bottom. Go back and do those again. Started with a small block that was only like 3/4 of an inch, and it made a hole in this 3/4 of an inch. And you started the seeds and the small block, and then you transplant them into the big block, and I soon realized that that was kind of tiring. Didn't really need to do that. You could just start them right off in here, and you're saving a step ahead of the game. You want to make sure you get that seed in there. I missed that one, so there's another one. Let this a little bit longer, a little longer, more. Pop it in. That seed didn't stick, so just wipe it off in there. Yep, there it is. Put another one in there just in case. This is a really handy little way of doing this. You can use a pencil, whatever. I use a Phillips head screwdriver. You'll see the point better. Use the seed in there, wet it a little bit more. Although it looks like it could be a pain in the neck, it's not really that bad. It works very well. And you get your seeds in place very well. So I'll finish that up and then I'll show you how we're going to cover these. Matter of fact, we'll just do that right now. Well, I'm almost there, so let's do that. Soil blocks are interesting because what happens with the soil block is you water from the bottom. Yep, you water from the bottom. Sorry about that. Water from the bottom, and it keeps the block moist all the way up through the block, and it helps promote root growth. Now when the roots get to the outside of the block, they just stop growing. They call it air block, or so they say. I missed that one right there, so I'm going to put one in there. Get in there, you little bugger. There it is. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take some mixture that I have and just pack a little bit on top, and then I'm done. Then you just water it from the bottom, and it's good to go. So let me reach behind here, and I'm just going to take a little blob on the top. On the top, I used to put some peat on top and then water the peat. And this is already wet, so it helps promote getting that seed ready to go. And there's a seed in there, seed in there, and that's all you do. It's very, very simple. And in a few weeks, a few days, these will start popping up. You don't want to push that in too hard. They'll start popping up and we have our lavender going. So right now I've got 24 plus 8, those 32 lavender plants started, seeds started. And I want to put a lot of lavender in. I'm going to do a nice lavender bed, I think, around the garden itself as a border, with just a little entranceway. Kind of clean that up just a tad. So there we go. Soil blocks 101. We'll be back sometime soon, show you how the plants came up. Right now, I got a whole mess of soil blocks I got to fill up. Thanks for watching Clean Slate Farm. See you later. Bye-bye.